down in Manila in the Philippines. We're learning Kuntaw. Yeah. And most important, I have my very good friend and master, Master Frank Aycocho. Master Frank, so good to see you again. So those of you who've been watching the show since the beginning, the very first episode of the show was shot right here in the Philippines with this man, Master Frank, beating me up in a park. And today we're in Master Frank's gym, and we're going to talk a little bit about fighting. Master Frank knows that my background, the thing that influenced me the most in martial art is boxing and Muay Thai and Brat Al Saray, Cambodian boxing. Tell me, what do you think about the way we punch in boxing versus the way you punch for Kuntaw?
Some are good, some are not good. Because it is all part, you don't even possess the right power of your punch. And not all punch should always have proper execution.
You talk a lot about execution, proper execution. Well, for Kuntaw is an art that absolutely emphasizes direct, correct action.
I am doing the training here. Yeah. You are going to follow that to complete it. I'm there. We want to introduce the right execution of a certain strike, like even a kick or a punch. It has to be in the proper posture. Otherwise, what is the use of your long time in practice without those things being introduced in the art of fighting? Once you execute it, the proper execution, you don't waste too many time and effort striking somebody. You need only one shocking strike.
When I'm staying here in Manila, I stay with Master Frank and his family, and he helps me train every day. And then when we're not training, we watch a lot of UFC videos together. And Master Frank is the best Monday morning quarterback, telling every one of those fighters what he did wrong. The big thing Master Frank always says to me is, the fight took too long. You know, even putting this uniform on, I forgot how to box. Anyway, we see with the boxing, all about throwing a combination of strikes, a lot of strikes, at my opponent. Now, in statistically, a professional boxer will throw about 120 to 180 punches per round. Less than 20% of those are going to land on his opponent. So over the course of 4 or 5 round fights, we're looking at hundreds and hundreds of punches that he's throwing. These men are big, strong men who practice hitting all day, and yet, they're not knocking the guy out when they hit him. Okay, Master Frank, tell me why.
The difference in there is, in that type of practice, you only develop your stamina to stay long in the fight. But you are not executing the right strike in that manner.
And you believe when the strike comes from the hip, it actually...
It has a lot of power, especially if you add the twisting of your hips. We need to slide a bit to extend the distance from there so that it has a more stronger power of execution. From here, once you touch it in there with the snappy strikes, retaliate it back or
retract.
One lesson that Master Frank always stresses to me is about the retraction, because a lot of people will throw a punch or throw a kick and just leave it sort of
hanging out there,
or only bring it halfway back. They're lazy. But then in real fighting, that means you're going to leave your body open.
Once you strike the punch and retaliate back your fist to the position, you have another chance to strike another one. That is a disadvantage against you, because your opponent might grab or break your arm.
Yeah. And Kuntaw, as we saw in the other videos that you and I did together, Kuntaw has a lot of grappling techniques in it.
Because I am going to break
that. A lot. You did a lot of things where you bent my arm and twisted my elbows. And... Hey, he's gonna get the distance. He's gonna measure the distance properly. The other thing is he's got this slide, which I think is actually very cool. This slide, and he's bringing his whole body forward. That slide.
Slide forward. Slide, following with the other leg, and reaching the distance for a block. And this comes down there, another on ground position. And stopping there, hitting inside. Then move back.
He's got a lot of snappy, crisp movement. And it's perfect movement. It comes straight back. You're not all over the place. Straight back, straight in. But you know I love boxing. Okay. But I've always believed that for one punch, we have a contest. Master Frank and I, if there was a computer sensor here, I'm certain that for one punch, you would punch harder than I would. I believe that. I believe the martial arts punch, the Kuntaw punch, for one punch would be a lot harder than my boxing punch, for a single punch. And then boxing, then we throw combinations, multiple punches. That's the difference.
Boom! This situation should always have the following power.
From the hips.
From the hips.
Same in boxing, right? A proper boxing hook for coming from the hip. Okay, and it's the same in Kuntaw. When you throw the straight punch, you're also right? Okay, you see that? Okay, he's twisting from the hip and he's using his legs, he's using his whole body weight. Now Master Frank probably weighs about 60 kilos. If you put 60 kilos concentrated on two knuckles,
right?
He will die. That's it. He said it simple. He will die.
Things are the combination of different instructor. How a technique is being executed against another type of martial arts. Because you don't stand alone like you know Kuntaw, but you do not know any other techniques. You only know about Kuntaw. There are disadvantages in there.
Master Frank told me that to become a true master of martial art, he believes you need to train to black belt level in about 5 different arts.
Correct.
That's what you told me. About 5 different arts, so you can see different approaches, different ideas.
Different philosophy in every art. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.